Something. Wait till they come to Boston. Toronto.
Leave us to ourselves. Don't leave us to our foolish thinking. Lord, we want all that you have, all that you have.
Yes.
And Lord, if it blows our little minds, let them be blown. Father, we want all of what you have, all of what you have. We thank you.
Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Lord just reminded me of the old hymn, where he leads, I will follow.
Drunk again.
Subject today is going to be the Holy Bible, a sure word of prophecy. Many of you have heard my testimony. Some of you who watch this video may know me or know of my testimony, but I'll just kind of rehash it very quickly and let people know where I'm coming from, why I'm dealing with this particular subject, why I think it's so important. Because we are living, I believe, in the last days, and I believe that there are things that we absolutely need to know. Not necessarily from the world, not necessarily from things of this world, but we need to know them. And I believe that our only source of knowledge in these last days is going to be God's Holy Spirit along with the Word of God. Those two always act together, and we'll see those things as we move forward in this presentation. My testimony is back in 1997, God spoke to my heart and He asked me to study Bible prophecy. And I always have had an inquisitive mind. I've always liked to look into things and study and research things. But I hadn't touched anything of a prophetic nature in years. And I just the way it was. I didn't look into anything like that. And the Holy Ghost, just sort of out of the blue, and I think it was around November 97, God said, let's study Bible prophecy. And I thought, well, great, I'll go get some books and read some books at the bookstore, find out the latest information on Bible prophecy, and maybe I'll get on the internet and find some things. And God said, hold on, wait a minute. I wrote a book on prophecy. I wrote the sure word of prophecy. And there are some things that I want to show you that are in that book. And I thought, well, what a novel idea. I think I'll try it that way. And I said, Lord, I'm fine with that. Just show me where to start, and I'll start. And God said, open it up and just begin reading, and I'll begin to show you some things. And one of my favorite verses in the whole Bible is Jeremiah 33:3. Call unto me, and I will answer thee and show thee great and mighty things that thou knowest not. Now, this presentation and this video is intended to help people study the Bible, help people understand some things from the Bible. But it's not intended to be the final authority. I am not a final authority on anything. the Word of God is, the Bible is, and that's what I believe, and that's what we're going to study in this particular presentation. You'll see the slides as they come up, and I'll have the Bible. Everything that I say, I want to be able to say biblically. I want to be able to stand upon the Word of God, because I'm going to show you that it is the final authority on everything. We have lots of information about that. We have another video on that particular subject, on the authority of the Scriptures. The authority of I believe, the King James Bible, 1611. And we have some videos on that. But I'm going to show you, and what I'm going to tell you and what I'm going to teach you is based upon what saith the Lord, or what saith the Scriptures. And so the things and the principles that we're going to learn, and even some things that toward the end of this presentation we're going to see that is absolutely startling, you will find them right in the pages of the Word of God. So I'm going to have them there displayed for you. Deuteronomy 29:29, the Bible says, "The secret things belong unto the Lord our God." Now notice the word, the phrase "secret things." I just kind of took some verses and I went through the Scriptures and I looked at the word "secret," found primarily in the Old Testament. And God did have secrets. God had knowledge that He retained, that He chose to give and transfer to mankind. We're going to find out just how important God transferring His secrets really are. So it says the secret things belong unto the Lord our God. God is the source of all of our knowledge. But those things which are revealed belong unto us and to our children forever. For what reason? That we may do all the words of this law. In other words, God is saying in this verse, He's saying, I have the secret things, I have secret knowledge, but I'm going to reveal them unto my people and unto their children, and I'm going to do it forever. In other words, God's saying there will never be a generation on this earth that will not have my word and my knowledge revealed to them. I'm going to do it. I'm going to reveal it to them forever and forever. And for what reason? That they may do all the words of this law. Now stop and think about what He's saying here. Stop and just think about what God's trying to get across to us here. Imagine if we lived in a country where the police had the right, or the military, or whoever. Let's imagine that we lived in a country where the police or the military had the right to pull you over, to come into your house and arrest you, and say that you broke the law, cast judgment upon you, imprison you, or kill you, and said that you broke the law. And you said, what law? And they were able to invent some law that they could come up with. They were able to manufacture law. Just if they saw you do something and they didn't like you doing it, they could just say, well, you know, we don't like that, and so we're going to arrest you and we're going to imprison you. No. We live in a country where the laws are written down. God cannot, this country, the police in this country, the judicial system of this country, cannot judge you and on things that are not written, on law that doesn't exist. It's not supposed to happen. Maybe it does, but it's not supposed to happen that way. They're only supposed to judge you on laws that are written down, on laws that are revealed, laws that can be plainly known. Even if you don't know every law that there is, how many of you know the tax code, memorize the tax code? We don't know all of that. But yet we still have to follow that law because it can be found out. And so God says, I have secret things and I am going to reveal it to you for one important reason, so that you can do what I tell you to do. You're going to know what is my law. Psalm 25 verse 14, the secret of the Lord is with them that fear Him, and He will show them His covenant. Now I want you to look at this. Back in Deuteronomy, He said that they said that the secret things belong unto us, are revealed unto us and to our children. He says here in Psalm 25:14, the secret of the Lord is with them that fear Him, and He will show them His covenant. I want you to notice that God is beginning to point out here in these verses that yes, to a group of people or to an individual or a nation who wants to know God's ways, God will reveal that to them. But as we're going to see, as we're seeing here already, and as we're going to see more and more, There are people who really don't want to know God's law. They really don't want to know God's salvation. They really don't want to know about God's grace and His mercy like we find out. They don't really want to know that. They would rather be lied to. And so I believe that God is going to allow them to be lied to. We're going to see that a little bit later on. In fact, 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 11 says, "For this cause God shall send them strong delusion that they should believe a lie." And I believe, folks, that we can see clearly in our country, in our churches, everywhere that we look, we can clearly see that lies are being told behind pulpits. Lies are being told, and God is allowing that because they're being told to people who really don't want to know the truth. So Psalm 25:14, "The secret of the Lord is with them that fear Him, and He will show them His covenant." Proverbs 3, verse 32, the Bible says, "For the froward is abomination to the Lord, but His secret is with the righteous." Now notice that God is drawing a line here. He said the froward, the proud, the arrogant is an abomination to the Lord. They would be over here. And His righteous people, or those people upon whom He has put His righteousness on, they are over here. God draws a line between them. The froward is abomination, but His secret, the things that He is going to reveal, is with the righteous. Now let me stop right here. You say, well, does that mean that lost people can never read a Bible? No, that doesn't mean that. In fact, a lot of lost people have read the Bible. Isaac Asimov was a science fiction writer, wrote countless. In fact, there was a movie that came out just a year or so ago called I, Robot, and it was based upon Isaac Asimov's short stories about robots. And Isaac Asimov wrote a commentary on the entire Bible, which means he read the Scripture cover to cover, page to page. He read and studied everything that was in there. And basically, if you look at his commentary, you'll see that he didn't believe any of it. He didn't believe the stories of the miracles that happened in the Old Testament. He didn't believe in the stories of Jesus there in the New Testament, and the miracles and the beginning of the church and people being raised from the dead. He didn't believe that stuff. So he died a lost man. He didn't want to believe. And so he read the same Bible that probably you and I read. And yet he didn't want the truth revealed to him. So he didn't have the truth. Proverbs 15, verse 29. "The Lord is far from the wicked." There we go again. God's separating them. "But He heareth the prayer of the righteous." What prayer is that? Well, it could be Jeremiah 33:3. "Call unto me, and I will answer thee, and show thee great and mighty things that thou knowest not." Colossians, now we're in the New Testament. Colossians chapter 3, verse 10. "And have put on the new man, which is renewed in knowledge after the image of Him that created him." Notice what this verse is saying. Have put on the new man. That new man refers to the born again experience. Are you born again? Are you saved? In other words, you don't just say, "Well, I'm a Christian," and not follow the Lord Jesus Christ. You don't just say, "I'm a Christian and I believe in God and I believe in Jesus." The Bible says the devils also believe and tremble. But are you a new man? Are you a new person? Are the old things in your life passed away, and all things in your life God is making brand new again? Do you still have all the old habits? Do you still have all the old sins? You still like to go to all the old places that you used to go to?